It was an early morning for these researchers as they loaded the boat for a 6 a.m. departure. As the research vessel departed Burlington Bay, there was still quite a bit of setup to do. A key piece is to find the correct depth in meters to successfully place the gill net to increase the chances of catching lake trout.
Gill netting is a wall of faintly invisible net, it's monofilament, that's going to trap fish in its meshes. A fish is going to swim towards a gill net, think it's not there, stick its head through one of the meshes, be startled probably, try and back up, and it will catch, usually it's a operculum, it's gill cover, in these meshes, and then it's trapped. And that's why it's called a gill net. They're caught by the gill cover. The size of fish you catch is dependent on the size of the mesh. It has to be big enough that the fish's face can fit through it, not so big the fish can go all the way through it. But by and large, it's size selective. So you set the size mesh towards the type of the size of fish that you want to get. You want small lake trout, you go for small mesh. Big lake trout, big mesh. The net itself is set up with a lead line, a weighted line, on the bottom of the panel of net, and it's got a float line or a float core line at the top. So unlike a trawl, which should be a head rope and a foot rope, this is going to be a float line and a lead line.
The first buoy is deployed as the boat slowly moves forward, followed shortly by the first anchor. After the anchor is set, the net is released as the boat slowly moves forward. If the net is packed properly ahead of time, then it should only require a bit of guidance to fall into the proper position. This is the most dangerous part of gill netting because if any part of your clothing becomes attached to the net, there is a high risk that you will go overboard and be pulled down with the net. Therefore, it is key to take precautions and take off any jewelry, watches, or other materials that might get caught in the net. The net is then left for a certain period of time, in this case an hour plus, depending on the research project involved. Once that time period is up, the buoys can be found using GPS coordinates. It is a team effort to collect the buoys, pull up the rope, lift the anchor, and eventually start hauling in the lead-weighted line. If a fish is caught in the gill net, special care is taken to remove it from the net without causing further damage. If all goes well, the fish should just slip right out of the net. However, this is not always the case. Gill nets can cause stress in fish, and some may die in them. To find out what the fish is eating, a lavage is used. This device pumps water into the fish's stomach, causing it to regurgitate its food. Data such as species, total length, sex, and presence of fin clips are recorded, as well as any irregularities such as lamprey wounds. After a long day, you can sit back and enjoy the view for a bit before returning to shore to begin unloading the gear and cleaning the boat deck.